Remember, this video is for study section for morphology and comparative anatomy of plant organs. Morphology is the science of form or structures of plants. It has to do with the study of the external features of plants and their parts, while anatomy describes the internal structure of plants and their parts. At the end of this study section, you should be able to 1. Discuss the anatomy of plant organs. 2. Describe the morphology of plant organs. Anatomy of plant organs. Anatomy deals with the study of gross internal details of plant organs like root, stem, and leaf, etc. Plants have 2 distinct organs, which are the shoot system and the root. Looking at the anatomy of plant roots under the anatomy of plant organs, this will be discussed in 2 ways using dicotyledon and monocotyledon roots. Features of a dicotyledon root include 1. Epilemia, which is the outermost layer, is comprised of the tubular living components. Epilemia is also known as rhizodonis of piliferous layer. 2. Cortex, which is made up of parenchymatous cells, chloroplast, which is absent, so they are non-photosynthetic. Cells of outer part of cortex are subarized in old roots. It is called exodermis. Endodermis. This layer is situated between the pericycle and the cortex. Passage cells provide part to absorb water from cortex to pericycle. 4. Pericycle, which is a single layer. It is composed of prosenchyma, lateral roots, which are originated from the part of the pericycle, which is lying opposite to protocilium, vascular bundles. Vascular bundles are radial and exarch, xylem and phloems, which are separate and equal in number. The last one is the pitch. In dicot, pitch is less developed or absent. Features of a monocotyledonous root are similar to that of a dicotyledonous root. In the monocotyledon roots, the internal structure of a typical monocotyledon root is similar to the features of the dicotyledon roots, although the number of xylem bundles are more than 6. In monocotyledon roots. Exceptionally, the number of xylem bundles are 2 to 6 in onion, and the pitch is very developed in monocotyledon roots. Another one is the anatomy of plant stem under anatomy of plant organs, which will also be discussed in 2 ways using the dicotyledon and monocotyledon stem. Dicotyledon stem. Features of a dicotyledon stem include 1. Epidermis. Epidermis is the outermost layer of the stem. It is single layered and lacks chloroplast, except in the gap cell. 2. Cortex. In dicotyledon stem, cortex are divided into 3 parts. We have the hypodermis, general cortex, and endodermis. Hypodermis. It is present just below the epidermis. It is a thick multicellular layer that provides additional support to epidermis, and it's composed of collenchyma cells and their cells, the general cortex. This part is composed of parenchyma cells. Storage of food is the main function of the cortex. Endodermis. It is single cell thick layer. It demarcates the cortex from the central cylinder. The pericycle. This layer is situated in between the endodermis and vascular bundles. Vascular bundles are arranged in a ring. Each vascular bundle is conjoint, collateral, and open. Each vascular bundle is made up of phloem, cambium, and xylem, and lastly the pitch, which spreads from the ring of vascular bundle to the center. It functions as storage for food and water. Features of a monocotyledon stem include 1. Epidermis. Epidermis is also the outermost single cell thick layer. It is covered with thick cuticle. Multicellular hairs are absent and stomata are also less. Hypodermis. Hypodermis of monocotyledon stem is made up of sclerenchyma. It is about 2 to 3 layers thick, which lies below the epidermis. 3. The grand tissue. The entire mass of parenchyma cells next to hypodermis and extended to the center is called grand tissue. 4. We have the vascular. 4. We have the vascular bundle. They are scattered in the grand tissue and are generally oval in shape. Vascular bundles surrounded by the layer of sclerenchymatous fiber are also known as bundle sheets. Vascular bundles consist of xylem and phloem. And lastly, which is the pitch, anatomy of plant leaf. The transverse section of the lip shows three regions. We have the epidermis, the maxillofacial, and the veins, also known as vascular bundles, with its different layers. One, the epidermis. The epidermis of lips is a continuous layer of cells on all surfaces of the lip, unbroken except for pores. Two, maxillofacial. The maxillofacial tube forms the bulk of most lips, and the chloroplasts in its cells are the principal sites of photosynthesis. The maxillofacial is sandwiched between the epidermal layers in layers held horizontally, and the maxillofacial is differentiated into palisade maxillofacial, that is, they are the layers of cells which are present below the upper epidermis. It plays a vital role in photosynthesis and consists of closely packed columnar cells with their long axes at right angles to the leaf surface. The lower tissues, called spongy maxillofacial, is made up of irregularly shaped cells, loosely arranged with much intercellular space. 3. The vascular tissue, also known as the veins. Veins penetrate all parts of the leaf, forming a network that connects the leaf through the petiole to the vasculature of the stem, and thereby to the roots as well. The vascular tissues are surrounded by a bundle sheet, one or two layers thick, composed of fibers in the smaller veins and parenchyma in the larger. Then we'll move on to morphology of plant organ. Morphology is the study of the external structure of plants and their parts. Every flowering plant consists of a shoot system and a root system. The shoot system is made up of stems and leaves, while the root system is made up of the roots only. Talking about morphology of plant roots, plant roots are multicellular organs which are present below the ground. Roots are developed from radicle of the embryo of a germinating seed in majority of the dicotyledonous plants. The direct elongation of the radicle leads to the formation of primary roots, which grows inside the soil. It bears lateral roots of several others that are referred to as secondary, tertiary roots, etc. The primary roots and its branches constitute the taproot system, example mustard plant. In monocotyledonous plants, the primary root is short-lived and is replaced by a large number of roots. These roots originate from the base of the stem and constitute the fibrous root system. Example of this is wheat plant. In some plants like grass, roots which arise from parts of the plants other than the radicle, and they are called adventitious roots. Characteristics of taproots are: one, they are the one main root from which smaller branches root. Characteristics of taproots are: one, they are the one main root from which smaller branch roots emerge with the absence of node. Two, they are the continuation of the primary roots. Three, they are involved in the storage of food and anchoring the plant. Characteristics of fibrous roots are one, they are finely branched secondary roots. They cover a large area and cannot go as deep as taproot. Three, they are more efficient absorption of water and minerals. Functions of the root system are: one, storing reserve food material. Two, synthesize plant growth regulators. And three, they provide a proper anchorage to the plant's part. Functions of the root system are: one, storing reserve. Characteristics of the root system are: one, they serve as storage reserve for food material. Two, they synthesize plant growth regulators. Three, they provide a proper anchorage to the plant's part. Regions of the roots are divided into various parts. We have: one, the root cap. The root apex is covered by a tube-like structure called the root cap, meristematic tissue. It is present a few millimeters above the root cap. The cells of this region are very small, thin-walled, and with dense protoplasm. 3. Root elongation. The cells of this region undergo rapid elongation and enlargement, and are responsible for the growth of the roots in length. 4. Region of maturation. The cells of this zone gradually differentiate and mature. From this region, some of the epidermal cells form very fine and delicate thread-like structures called roots here. Modification of roots. Roots are modified for food storage, they are modified for support, and 3, they are modified for respiration. Examples of taproots and fibrous roots are: 1, conical roots. They are fleshly tap roots that resemble a cone. Example of this is carrot. Tuberous roots. These are swollen without any definite shape. Example is root potato. Fusiform root. The primary root is spindle shape. It is swollen in the middle and gradually tapers at both the ends. Example is radish. And then morphology of plant stem. Stem is the ascending part of the axis, bearing branches, leaves, flowers, and fruit. Branches of the stems are 1. Spreading out branches, bearing leaves, flowers, and fruits. 2. They conduct water. Branches of the stems are 1. They help in spreading out branches, bearing leaves, flowers, and fruit. 3. They conduct water, mineral, and photosynthesis. 3. Some stems perform the function of storage of food, support, protection, and of vegetative propagation. Modification of stems. Stems are modified for food storage. 2. They are modified for support. 3. They are modified for defense. 4. They are modified for photosynthesis. And lastly, they modify for vegetative propagation. Morphology of plant leaf. The leaf is a lateral, generally flattened structure borne on the stem. It develops exogenously at the node and bears a bud in its axis. Parts of a leaf. We have 1. Leaf base. The leaf is attached to the stem by the leaf base and may bear 2 lateral small leaves like structures called stipules. 2. Petiole. The petiole helps hold the blade to the leaf blade. The leaf blade, which is also known as lamina, is a green expanded part of the leaf with veins and veinlets. We have the leaf margin. This is the external boundary of a leaf. And lastly, the leaf apex, which is the terminal end of a leaf, that is the tip of a leaf. Functions of a leaf are 1. They help on the manufacture of food by the chloroplast. Functions of the leaves are 1. It helps in the manufacture of food by the functions of leaves. Functions of the leaves are 1. It helps in the manufacture of food by the chloroplast. 2. It helps in the interchange of gases between the atmosphere and the plant organ. 3. They are organs of vegetative propagation. Another major importance to look into is flower. A flower plays a vital role in producing fruits and in attracting insects for pollination. They contain the sexual organs for the plant. It is meant for sexual reproduction. A typical flower has 4 different kinds of whorls arranged successfully on the swollen end of the stalk or pedicel called thalamus or receptacle. These are calyx, corolla, andrecium, and gynoecium. Calyx and corolla are accessory organs, while andrecium and gynoecium are reproductive organs. Parts of a flower are 1. Calyx, also known as sepals. These are the outer covering of the flower bud, which protects the stamens and the pistils during the bud stage. The corollas, also known as the petals. The petals are bright in color, which helps in protecting stamen and pistils and are mainly responsible for attracting insects for pollination. They are collectively known as the corolla. Andrecium, also known as the stamens, represent the male reproductive organ. Each stamen consists of a stalk or a filament and an anther. That is, anther and filament are collectively called the male reproductive part of the flower. Gynoecium, also known as carpels. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part of the flower. A carpel consists of 3 parts. We have the stigma, we have the star, and ovary. Ovary is the enlarged basal part on which lies the elongated tube, the star. Thanks for listening. You can read more about this section in your study material. See you in the next class.